Hi, I'm Anila Dhami. You're watching BritAsia TV, and today I am interviewing the Queen of Bollywood, the legend, the lady who's featured in many massive Bollywood films, including some of my favourites, including Dilwale Dulhania Le Jayenge, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, and Kabhi Khushi Kabhie Gham. She needs no more introduction. It's the one and only Kajol. Kajol, thank you so much for your time today.
My pleasure.
How's London treating you?
Awesome, as usual. Yeah. I've been coming here for like every year in the summer for like years and years and years now.
Amazing.
So yeah, I love it. It's a beautiful city.
Great. And you're here for a special reason.
I am. I'm here to promote Helicopter Eela.
And tell us about it.
Helicopter Eela is basically about a mother. It's a relationship. It's a story about a relationship between a mother and a son. Mm-hmm. And it's about the fact that you know, moms sometimes lose their identity and become only moms, and they don't know what else they can do with themselves.
Absolutely,
at some point, because of the fact that they're so, you know, oh, my son. And Eela is actually, Helicopter Eela is a kind of a coming of age film for her more than him. And my son is being played by Radhi Sen.
Amazing.
And he is an absolutely fabulous actor, mm-hmm. who is just very young, 19 years old, celebrated his 19th birthday with me on set.
Oh, that's nice.
So yeah, on set he had his birthday on the last day of shoot, actually. So yeah. I mean, he's such a sweet boy, and he's already won a national award. I was like, oh my god,
it's amazing. Actually, I was going to say, because he's so young, it's amazing that he got that massive opportunity to be in a Bollywood film and work alongside yourself.
He is, but he's already won an award for a Bengali film that he's done.
That's incredible.
A national award for a Bengali film that he's done.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know, kudos to you, and hope you go from strength to strength.
I'm sure he will, especially with the box hits that you're going to have with this film.
Definitely, no two ways about it.
And I mean, you talk about the kind of mother element to this film.
Right.
How important was that for you to play that part?
It was very, very, it was more than the mother element. I think Helicopter Eela just had a fabulous script.
Yeah.
The way it was put together, and what it says, the message behind it is really, really, it's a nice message, but done in a very, very nice way, done in a funny way, done in a humorous way, done in a way that does not feel like it's being shoved down your throat for some godforsaken reason, you know? The whole relationship between the mother and son is so identifiable. Like, everybody will see their mother in them, and themselves in them as well. So I think it's one of those films that, you know, you will immediately, oh my god, it's a me too.
Did you feel like that when you were
definitely
playing that role?
I mean, it felt a little too comfortable, actually.
Do you know what? I'm not even a mum yet, but I get that. I'm like, oh my god, I love my children already.
Yeah.
I love them so much.
Yeah,
I'll be one of those unbearable mums.
No, not only that. I mean, the fact of the matter is that Eela, you know, there's a dialogue in the film where she says that he just doesn't know how much he needs me. He just hasn't figured out how much he needs me.
And will always need me.
Yeah, and he will always need me, exactly. He just doesn't know how much he needs me, and he will never stop needing me. So, I mean,
Until the wife comes along.
After that as well. That's never going to stop.
That's never going to stop. Why was it a boy, I have to ask? Why was it a son and not a daughter?
Because I think the film required it. The film required it to be a boy at that point in time because of certain reasons in the film or whatever. And we just thought it would be a very, very interesting take on it, because we've had, you know, father-daughter constantly. We've had mother-daughter constantly. We haven't really seen a mother-son relationship in, you know, in a while. So I think, and it's the span of his is that, you know, from the time that he's a kid to the time that he's 19 years old in the film. So it's 18 years old in the film. And, you know, you just feel like, oh my god, you know, I so get where she's coming from. So,
And this is your return after quite some time.
In a Hindi film, yes.
Yes.
I don't know, not really quite some time. Dilwale released about 3 years back. So,
well, that's true. But in that period, in quite some time now, you've been a mother.
Yeah.
And Ajay, your husband, has been a father.
Right.
How did
And a producer.
How did parenthood change, or if it did, change your dynamic with your working world? Because Bollywood, you know, we see actors and actresses traveling for films, long shoots. Did you feel that at any point you were affected in any way?
I think that I just, I wouldn't say affected, but it was, like I said, a personal choice with my kids. As soon as I gave birth to Nissa, I was very clear that I'm not going to do, you know, I'm not going to go for long outdoors, or I'm not going to, you know, take too many, work too much. Anyway, I was not working that much. I mean, according to everybody, I'm probably the least worked actor in the entire film industry.
I absolutely do not agree.
I'm the least worked actor, really. I'm seriously.
Well, you don't need to anyway. You're Kajol, you don't need to.
So anyway, I just thought that I was, that I needed to take that time out to be with my kids, spend time with them. And I honestly wanted to. I had kids because I wanted to have them. And I think that I wanted to bring them up the way I wanted to bring them up. And I had to be there to bring them up, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So, I mean, I think that that's something that, again, I would say that's a personal choice. And I have to say that fortunately for me, everybody respected my decision. And even though I worked after that, everybody was very correct about it, from, you know, my name is Khan to Fana to Yumi or Ham or whatever I did after that was all, you know, everybody understood my boundaries and respected me for them. Yeah.
Well, that's amazing. Yeah. And you have been around in Bollywood from the beginning, at least my beginning, because, you know, I used to, on a Friday, I'd sit with my grandparents, and that would be our Bollywood night on a Friday with my sisters, and we'd watch all the movies and all of your big hits. You know, I have spent hours in cinemas crying, watching Kabhi Khushi Kabhie Gham, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. How has Bollywood changed since you first began?
Since I first began, a lot, because I have to say that I was one of those lucky, lucky people who was in Bollywood before cell phones. Before technology came in this huge wave and hit and, you know, kind of made everything completely different and changed everything so completely. So I had a little bit of that world.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we had this world, which started up, I think, you know, by the time I was 20, 21, we had cell phones coming in, these really huge structures. And so I still got, you know, a little bit of a feel of what my mom used to feel like when she was working. And I identified with it so much. And then you come here where you have, you know, everything is corporatized and everything is much more, you know, planned, and everything is much more comfortable. Work is much more comfortable.
Okay.
So that is a completely different, it's a completely different scene today than it was. And of course, the fact that, you know, digital has just changed. The fact that we as actors just have, I don't know, blown up.
Become much closer. To people as well now.
Yeah, become much closer to the general public. We've somewhere down the line lost our mystery. We've somewhere down the line lost our.
Do you like that?
I think that was the charm of people like my mother, people like my aunt, people like, you know, Dharminder or Sunny Deol for that matter, or, you know, all the older generation, or a Rajesh Khanna or an Amitabh Bachchan for that matter. There is a certain mystery, there is a certain mystique about the film industry where you're always looking at it and like, oh my God, they are stars literally from another galaxy. So yes, that's not there anymore. I don't believe that's there anymore, but today is a different world. And today, you know, the more touchable you are, the more identifiable you are, the more relatable you are.
So you have been in Bollywood for a long time now, but audiences here, I would say, would think that it's changed in the sense of the way that women are portrayed. So when it comes to women, you know, a lot of people are saying that they're being used with their item numbers to sell a movie, the item songs. What do you think about the way that Bollywood treats and portrays women?
I don't think that, I think movies reflect society. I think movies are simply a reflection. They do not lead society, they reflect society. What society is thinking is what the movies reflect. So yes, we may influence them up to a certain extent, but basically we are reflections of what society is going through right now. And I have to say, currently, I'm so happy that our audiences are willing and able to accept different kinds of cinema. We're willing to look at, you know, different genres. We're looking at new genres, which were never there before. I cannot imagine a Helicopter Eela being made 15 years back. 15, 20 years back. I cannot imagine that film being funded. Nobody would fund it. You know, it would be economically impossible to make a film like that.
That is to an extent that it reflects, but then it does impact and influence too, because Bollywood is such a powerhouse, you know, and people watch Bollywood films and they see what they're, you know, and they want to replicate what they see on screen.
Yeah.
So do you not think it then does to an extent have an impact?
It does. I'm not saying it doesn't, but I'm saying it's to an extent.
Right.
Basically, we are reflections of society, and as we see the films getting, we see the genre of films changing, we realize that again we are reflecting society, because society is changing. Your audience is changing. Your audience is willing to see new stuff. Your audience is willing to has a more open mind and willing to accept different kinds of films coming at you, and that makes it a fabulous time right now for all actors to be in the film industry. We have it's a lovely, lovely time to be in the film industry currently.
Okay, you come across as a strong, bold woman, right? And we see lots of things like with Hollywood and the Me Too movement.
Right.
How have you dealt with, or you know, have you had to deal with any of those kinds of scenarios within your kind of career, or any kind of advice you could give to women that would help them stand up for themselves if they had experienced anything of the sort?
Honestly, I have never had that kind of a scenario happen to me. I have not.
Touch wood.
Which is great, which is fabulous. But yes, you know, I've heard about it. And yes, there is a certain, you know, kind of, there is a certain kind of way, again, that, you know, you're looking at. That people look at, you know, newcomers, etc. So yes, there is that. But I also think that is not specific only to the film industry.
No, it is definitely not specific
to the film industry. We're talking about industries all over.
We're talking about
any job place, any employment place that you have. It's not specific to the film industry at all. And that's something that, you know, like I'm so glad that people are standing up and talking about it. I'm so glad that, you know, women are talking about it and not saying that, you know, we need to be ashamed. We don't need to be ashamed.
Yeah.
You need to be ashamed of it.
Yeah.
And you will not be ashamed of it till somebody stands up and makes it public.
Yeah. Yeah. Of course.
Yeah. So I think, like I said, it is so nice to know that, you know, that's the one great thing about the media currently, is that all you need to do is put out one tweet or, you know, one post or one video and it goes viral. You don't have to, you know, be standing up in a court of law or,
absolutely.
It doesn't have to be a process to get your point across.
Yeah. Moving into other territory, I don't think we can talk to you without talking to you about Shah Rukh Khan. You two are on-screen legends. I could probably start crying just talking about you both. What makes you work? What is it that gives you that on-screen chemistry that makes us all want to tune into your films?
I have no clue. I really have no clue. I think he's a fabulous actor. I do believe that. I think he's a fantastic, a little underrated, in fact.
Really? You think so?
I think so, because there's so many, you know, he's one of those people who can probably do anything that you give him.
Yeah, he really can.
He chooses not to,
but
he really can. And I feel that now maybe he's coming into his own. You know, he has a lot of other films coming out, and different kinds of films, etc.
Yeah.
So yes, definitely. As far as our chemistry on screen is concerned, I think you know, it's like I said in another interview. Actually, it's more, you know, the intangible that you can't really put your finger on, that people just like, it's just there. That's probably our friendship, you know, probably we've known each other for so long.
Yeah.
You know, there's a certain comfort level in working with somebody whom you've worked with for years and years and years. There's a certain unconscious body language about it.
Yeah.
That, you know, that is there between friends. I think that's what comes across.
Yeah,
on screen
does. You're
as
both
well.
So natural together.
Yeah, it doesn't feel forced.
No.
It doesn't feel like as though you're watching two people who don't really know each other,
try
to fall in love with each other or whatever.
And it feels like there's always some kind of continuation between your story.
Probably also because of the kind of films that we've done.
Yeah.
I have to say that it also has to do with the fact that most of the films that we've done have been super hits, you know, and it just feels like there's an on-screen history that everybody has watched.
Yeah, and
so
we've really
not like
followed
it's you. Like episode 23 that you're on already.
Yeah. That's exactly what it's like. I could tell you all of my favorite moments, but I won't even go into that right now. What's been your favorite moment with Shah Rukh?
My favorite moment, I don't have one, honestly. I really don't have one. We've done such fabulous films together, from Bazigar to, you know, to My Name is Khan.
Yeah.
To K3. We've done so many, and
so
we've had
many.
So much. We've just had some good times to Dilwale, in fact.
Yes. I was going to say, and Gerua, so, what a hit song.
Yeah, so I mean, we've really had, you know, we've really had great fun, and we've worked well together.
Yeah. I will just share my one favorite moment, and it's when you put your hand out and after saying no music, hand out, and that dance in the rain in Kuch Kuch Hota Hai is just epic. Love that.
Cool.
Looking back at your entire career, what film would you say has been your favorite? Apart from this one, of course.
I don't know. I have no clue. Because I think each and every one of my films has taught me something.
Amazing.
That has been particular to that film.
Mm.
Each and every one of my films has made something of me, has contributed to something, to who I am today, in small, small ways.
Yeah.
And I think, like I say, that, you know, my next film will have a little bit of Helicopter Eela in it. Yeah. So, I think that each and every one of my films has been very, very special to me.
And I just want to touch on very quickly, you work as a social activist and you're a UN ambassador for better sanitation across the world. Why was that important to you?
It was important to me because of the fact that actually we started with Help a Child Reach 5.
Mm-hmm.
And we started with Help a Child Reach 5, and you know, they came to me and they gave me all these statistics, and I was like, okay, so I mean, what do you want me to say?
Yeah.
And they were like, you know, it's a simple fact that we just want you to tell people that it's important in this day and age to wash your hands with soap and water. And I was like, why is that important?
Why
is that over and
so
above?
Because it's so basic, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so basic. And that's another thing that I realized, is that just because it's basic and simple doesn't mean that it's not effective and necessary.
Right.
And the simple fact of the matter is that today the world has changed.
Mm.
We have viruses that we've never heard of.
Yeah.
We have viruses that we will never hear of.
Mm.
And you know, like I say it in Hindi, jaise kehte hai na, ki mitti badal gayi hai. Yahan ki mitti badal gayi hai. Jahan pe aap pehle purane zamane mein mitti lagate the, ghav pe mitti lagate the. तो आज के जमाने में अगर आप लगाओगे तो आपको सेप्टिसीमिया हो जाएगा यू नो यू विल गेट यू विल हैव टू बी टेकन टू द डॉक्टर एंड टोल्ड यू माइट नीड टू कट योर फुट ऑफ सो आई मीन द लैंड हैज चेंज्ड द वर्ल्ड हैज चेंज्ड एंड वी हैव टू चेंज विद द वर्ल्ड एंड व्हाट अर्लियर यूज्ड टू बी अ हैबिट दैट यू वर टॉट बाय योर पेरेंट्स यू नो इट वाज अ हैबिट बेटा हाथ मुंह धो के बैठना खाने के लिए यू नो और यू नो यू हैव टू वॉश योर हैंड्स बिफोर डिनर इट्स एज सिंपल एज दैट व्हाट वी वर टॉट एज चिल्ड्रन वी फॉरगॉट एज एडल्ट्स बट व्हाट वी हैव टू रियलाइज इज दैट इट्स नेसेसरी एज ह्यूमन बीइंग्स टुडे इन दिस करंट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इन दिस करंट वर्ल्ड टू लर्न हाउ टू वॉश योर हैंड्स विद सोप एंड वॉटर एंड रियलाइज दैट इट विल मेक अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस टू गो आउट एंड टीच इट टू एवरीबडी अराउंड यू एंड इट इज नॉट रॉकेट साइंस इट डज नॉट नीड लिटरेसी इट डज नॉट नीड यू नो अ PhD डिग्री
Yeah,
it's as simple as that. And we actually conducted studies in states like Bihar and UP, where we took a village. And we had cases of pneumonia and diarrhea coming down by 37%.
Oh my God,
in
wow.
6 months.
Wow, so it's really effective.
Exactly,
just by going
in there and teaching the kids and telling them to go back and tell their families that they have to wash their hands with soap and water 5 times a day.
That is
it's
amazing.
As simple as that. 37%?
That is huge, in six months.
Imagine what we could do as a country. Imagine what we could do in the world. And our country has one of the highest rates of child mortality. Imagine how many children we would save.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
I think every child deserves to reach the age of 5.
Absolutely.
No child deserves to, you know, it's every child's birthright.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, you should give them their birthright. And if one of the ways is simple but effective, why not?
I think that is an amazing note to leave our viewers on. Kajol, thank you so much. And we can see Helicopter Eela on our screen.
Releasing on the September the 14th. Please go watch it. It's a happy film. It's the kind of film that you want to watch with your family, without your family, and with everybody else as well.
Amazing. It was the one and only, the fabulous Kajol. I'm Anila Dhami, and you're watching BritAsia TV.